So, Dr. Scholz, we have a patient who's in the process of staging their Gleason 8 prostate cancer. Their bone scans are clear, but the CT and the Axumin PET scan discovered suspicious lymph nodes, and they're waiting for the biopsy results to confirm. The radiation oncologist is asked, like, they want to do a PSMA PET scan, but he doesn't think it'd be very valuable because there's already been a situation where the Axumin PET scan picked up the lymph nodes, and they want to know what you think.
Well, that's a good point. Once you have established disease spread outside the prostate, you're kind of obligated to go full court press with treatment. So that would be like 18 months of Lupron+Zytiga. Might even talk about a short course of Taxotere based on some recent publication at the ASCO meetings showing that the Taxotere seems to add something more to the Lupron+Zytiga. What could we discover on a PSMA PET scan that you wouldn't see on an Axumin? Well, you might find additional lymph nodes some other place outside the pelvic region, or even an early bone met that would benefit from radiating that spot. I suppose it depends on how easy access is to the PSMA PET scan. I would definitely get if they had easy access. If it's going to be a long involved process and difficult to obtain the scan, then maybe it is reasonable just to go ahead and give all the treatment that you would normally give.
So PSMA PET scans are about $3,000 out of pocket currently, correct?
Right. It's sort of a dynamic situation. We're hoping that the Medicare billing codes will get worked out quickly and that these things will start being covered by normal insurance and become more widely available. Right now, it's mostly just at a few limited academic centers.
And as far as early use of Taxotere, you know, if they're getting radiation plus systemic therapies like Lupron+Zytiga, so hormone therapy, and then early use of Taxotere, is there any concern for having so many treatments at once and any quality of life issues that need to be looked at?
Definitely. I mean, Taxotere has its own side effects. You can't give it at the same time as the radiation. So typically what happens is people go on the hormone therapy, the Lupron+Zytiga, have the radiation, make sure they get through that well, and then consider maybe 4 to 6 cycles of Taxotere thereafter. But there is a, you know, depending on a patient's age and fitness, all these treatments can cause fatigue, and it can become cumulative or even excessive in some patients. So you have to kind of take it on an individual case basis. Sometimes when there's doubts, we'll tell patients to consider taking one Taxotere treatment, see how they tolerate it, and then decide on the basis of how they tolerate it whether they want to do any further treatment.
And using Taxotere earlier in the treatment sequence, would that eliminate them from being able to use it later, like Xofigo does and only has the one-time use, or can they use Taxotere later as well?
They certainly can use it later. And this whole idea of giving Taxotere, which is a mild type of chemotherapy, at the time of diagnosis is a policy called adjuvant therapy, which is used routinely in lung cancer, breast cancer, colon cancer. And it doesn't preclude the later use of chemotherapy if there's a future relapse.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.